Hi guys, I have a Teleflex C-Star helm pump, and the last season we noticed with my wife, we have a major oil leak all the time at the front. A good thing is the leak wasn't at the back, it was at the front, so the oil was coming down all the time next to the steering. I got to that point, I think either I changed the pump, but was nothing wrong with the pump. The pump was working perfectly, just some reason, somehow, it just started to lose oil. So I looked at the internet, all these, and I couldn't find anything, and I said, why would I change it? The pump was working perfectly, just leaking oil. Even when I refilled it, the pump was working if I tried to get the air out. But, you know, after a couple hours, it started to leak and, you know, starting to lose oil. So end of the season, I decided I'd take it out from the boat. Let's see if I could assemble it and disassemble it. The pump already disassembled from the top part. So that's how it looks like. The first thing I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna try to protect all the port. So no dust going in. So when I do the oil, it's not gonna have a problem with the bleeding out. So I just put some tape on it, electrical tape, which probably will work. Here, another one here. We just don't want any dust or dirt going in, and then just make the pump even worse. That's gonna be a bit tough. We're gonna try put something here. I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna make some damage on it, but just in case, if any dust going in or any particle in the top part also. Something like that. The reason I'm gonna take it apart, I wanna take that seal out, and because the leak was here, we noticed, you know, when we took the steering off, the oil was just coming down like hell in here, which the seal looks good, but for some reason it's still leaking. So I'm gonna take it apart, and I'm gonna take the seal, and when it's on the part, probably I'm gonna change everything on it, because I could buy a kit for that. So first of all, what I did, I just made a hole in the plywood, nothing fancy. So I could have the pump like that, so I could take all the bolt out. So I made a hole there, so that's gonna fit there. Of course, I put some homemade something there, so it's still straight. So I noticed also all the bolts, everything painted at the back, so I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have a hard time to take it apart, because even the Allen wrench, of course, you know, Allen wrench, it doesn't really fit in. So I think I have to play with it to go in and hammer it in. That's why I have a hammer here. So I want to make sure it sits properly, because I could screw up the bolt very easy. As you see, it's very tight. And then, of course, it's very tight because it's painted. I'm having a hard time. Like that. It's very tight. Like even that. Right. Try one more time. At least it got loose. But okay, it's going now. That's one. Of course, I'm not gonna want you guys watch all the video to taking screws out, so I'm gonna speed up from here. So I take one out, and let's see the other one. Actually, before I did, I marked the housing and the back with a small marker, just in case I have to put it back in the same way. So I really marked it here. It's nothing major, just a scratch, so that's not gonna make damage on the pump. So one is out. So something I have to tell you guys, I'm not a professional mechanic, but I'm capable to doing small things on the car, and everything on the mechanic. So if I make any big mistake, well, I'm not a mechanic. If I do something backwards, which you don't like, well, life is short. And I like to work on things like that, so I don't care. So the last one. This is the last one. I'm pretty sure it's gonna come apart very hard since the bolts are that tight. Probably everything's gonna be super tight. Okay, the last one. Now, all the bolts are out. Let's see how that's gonna come apart. I think probably has a lot of oil coming through this thing too, so I'm gonna put some rack here, just in case. Because I drained it, but still probably oil come inside. So I think if I could push this one, should come out. I don't want to really tap it hard, so I'm going to try with this. Of course, it doesn't want to go. Oh, there we go. It doesn't look very nice. It looks like water got in, or it totally discolored. I don't know why. That's doesn't make sense, but anyway, so that's what it is. We have two washers here. Oh no, a bunch of washer and the bearing. So I think that was like that. I tried to put everything back as in order, so when I assemble it, I'm not gonna have hard time. So I think that was like that, and was like that. Yeah, that's the bearing inside also. So I put this aside because I really want to take this one apart, and I have no idea how that's gonna look like. Looks like there was a small seal here, which probably will come with the kit, because I'm gonna buy a kit if I could recognize what size. And that's the other problem I'm having. When I took it out of the boat, all the label, no labels on it, so I have no idea how big is that pump. So I have to take it somewhere to identify what kind of kit I have to buy. So anyway, that's a part, and let's see if I could pull this apart, because that's all the reason we want to take it apart. So make sure I'm not gonna lose anything. The water, the oil is very bad, very bad. I don't know why it's like that color, which tells me something has happened with this. So anyway, there's a bunch of bearing inside. And yeah, we could see on the shaft also, because that was the seal here. Maybe some mark, the oil, I don't know. Doesn't look that bad. Doesn't look that bad. Well, anyway, it's a part. And so I put this one out too. We have it on the video, so that was sitting like that. Which, let me take it apart. So a bearing looks super fine for me, and okay, that was like that. Yeah, the oil is very bad. It shouldn't be like that. And there we go. That's the, hopefully that bearing doesn't fall apart. No, it sits properly. So now so I'm gonna put it in a bag or a rag. I wanna save all the parts. It's very fine stuff in here, which not cheap. So we're gonna see if we could fix it up and it will work. Of course, gonna have another video when I change all the seal and I get the parts. So that was here also. And that's the one. So now we're gonna take this apart. I mean, there's a lot of weight to take it apart. You just pull it out. Probably that was all the simple thing. Just pulled it out with my finger, so it was nothing hard. And I think that's the problem we had, which doesn't look bad. But anyway, we saw oil was coming from the front, not from the back. So that's enough reason to change this one, and might as well get the kit and change everything, seal inside. And we're gonna test on the board how that's gonna work. Anyway, I think that's it, guys. The next video I'm gonna make when we get the parts, and we're gonna assemble it. And of course, there's gonna be another video when we put it in a boat, and we're gonna test it how it works. That's it. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.
And the video is compliment of his wife Eva.
Okay,
big sacrifice.